డియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్, వెల్కమ్ టు ఈపీజీ పాఠశాల. టుడే వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డీల్ విత్ ది మాడ్యూల్ వేదాంగాస్ ఇన్ ది పేపర్ వేదిక్ ఎపిక్ అండ్ పురాణిక్ కల్చర్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా. ఐ ఆమ్ ప్రొఫెసర్ కోరాడ సుబ్రహ్మణ్యం, యూనివర్సిటీ ఆఫ్ హైదరాబాద్. టుడే వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది యాక్చువల్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ వేదాంగాస్ అండ్ ద డీటెయిల్స్ దేర్ ఇన్ బ్రీఫ్లీ. ది టర్మ్ వేదాంగాస్ ఈజ్ రిలేటెడ్ టు వేద, అండ్ వెన్ ది వేద ఈజ్ టు బి వేదిక్ లిటరేచర్ ఈజ్ టు బి అండర్స్టుడ్, దెన్ వన్ హ్యాస్ టు స్టడీ సిక్స్ సిస్టమ్స్ కాల్డ్ వేదాంగాస్ దట్ ఆర్ క్లోజ్లీ అసోసియేటెడ్ విత్ వేదిక్ కల్చర్. ది మాస్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ called Veda is considered to be eternal, that means without any beginning or end, and was discovered by sages. They contain literature that is useful for human beings in terms of ethics and spirituality. The Vedic culture can chiefly be divided into two parts, the former dealing with rituals that would cause transitory results, and the latter which deals with knowledge that causes freedom from the cycle of birth and death. In order to understand the Indian culture that is stood on four pillars called Purusharthas, or the purposes of life, namely Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha, the cycle of birth, the term Dharma is untranslatable as it is pregnant with meaning. It can be duty or the right path, etc., etc. Veda is described as the text from where Dharma has originated. That means Veda is the origin of Dharma. In other words, the way of life that is advocated by Indian tradition is called Sanatana Dharma or Eternal Dharma. It is not a religion, which means a system acceptable to a group of people. That means Dharma cannot be translated as a religion, but people have been doing the same, and it is a mistake. Religion is applicable to a particular thing that is acceptable to a group of people only, whereas Dharma is universal and it is applicable and acceptable to the entire universe. That is what we are going to decide. The way of life that is advocated by Indian tradition is called Sanatana Dharma. Satyam Vada, speak the truth, or Dharmanchara, live in a way that is not devoid of Dharma. Ahimsa Paramo Dharma, non-violence is the best Dharma, etc. are universals, that is to applicable to all human beings and not to any particular group. Then, so Sanatana Dharma is preached by Veda and its ancillaries that are an integral part of Vedic literature is meant for a comfortable living of mankind in terms of Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha. Therefore, the tradition of the term, the translation of the term Dharma as a religion is not faithful. Bad translation, that is to say religion is equal to Matam, liked by some people, also fails to prove that religion means Dharma. What is Dharma? Now we have to discuss the question of as to what is the particular thing that you are referring to by the name Dharma. It is a quintessential system of life whereby the universe is upheld. Dhriyate aneneti dharma. Then what happens? The earth is upheld by this. So the one that upholds the earth, that is to say the life of people, etc., is called Dharma. The insinuation is that in case people neglect or deviate from Dharma, then starts the decay of the universe that will be miserable. Then what is Veda? We have to explain the very concept of Veda. Vidya, it literally means knowledge. In Indian tradition, there are 14 centers or disciplines of knowledge. So, Purana Nyaya Mimamsa Dharma Shastranga Mishritaha Vedaha Sthanani Vidyayaha Dharmasya Chaturdasha. This is the verse from Yajnavalkya Smriti. Smriti means a Dharma Shastra, a code of conduct which follows the Shruti or Veda. సో ది హియర్ ది 14 విద్యా స్థానంస్ ఆర్ ఎన్యూమరేటెడ్ పురాణం న్యాయ దట్ ఈస్ న్యాయ దర్శనం అండ్ మీమాంస పూర్వమీమాంస అండ్ ధర్మశాస్త్రం కాల్డ్ స్మృతి అంగ వేదాంగాస్ వేదాంగాస్ ఆర్ శిక్ష వ్యాకరణం ఛందస్ నిరుక్తం జ్యోతిషం అండ్ కల్ప దిస్ సిక్స్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ వేదాంగాస్ అండ్ వేదా ఋగ్వేద యజుర్వేద సామవేద అండ్ అథర్వవేద ఫోర్ వేదాస్ సో ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ అబోడ్స్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ అండ్ ఆల్సో అబోడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ధర్మ ది ఫోర్ వేదాస్ సపోర్టెడ్ బై 18 పురాణాస్ కామ న్యాయ మీమాంస ధర్మశాస్త్ర అండ్ ది సిక్స్ వేదాంగాస్ దట్ ఆర్ ఆల్రెడీ సెడ్ దీస్ 14 ఆర్ ది అబోడ్స్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ అండ్ ధర్మ విష్ణు పురాణం ఎన్యూమరేట్స్ 18 అబోడ్స్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ బై యాడింగ్ 4 ఉపవేదాస్ ఎర్లియర్ యు హ్యావ్ ఎన్యూమరేటెడ్ 14 విద్యాస్థానంస్ బట్ విష్ణు పురాణం యాడ్స్ 4 మోర్ ఉపవేదాస్ యాన్సలరీస్ ఆఫ్ వేద నేమ్లీ ఆయుర్వేద ధనుర్వేద గాంధర్వ వేద అండ్ అర్థశాస్త్ర దీస్ 4 ఆర్ యాడెడ్ అండ్ 14+4 టోటల్ దేర్ ఆర్ 18 విద్యాస్థానంస్ ఆర్ అబోడ్స్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ వేదాంగాస్ నౌ వేదాంగ మీన్స్ వేద ప్లస్ అంగ అంగ మీన్స్ లింబ్ ఆర్ అవయవ ది ఇఫ్ యు టేక్ వేద యాజ్ ఎ పురుష యాజ్ ఎ పర్సన్ దెన్ దీస్ 6 ancillaries are called limbs of that purusha are useful in understanding the Vedic literature. The word anga means a limb. If we consider Veda as a person, knowledge personified, then the angas are limbs. The relation between Veda and Vedangas is called angangibhava or the relation of constitute and constituents. Shastram is a synonym of Vedanga. Pananiya Shiksha, a popular work on phonetics, describes the above aspect. Chandah padavutu vedasya hastavu kalpotha pachyate jyotisham ayanam chakshuhu niruktam shrotram uchyate Shiksha ghranantu vedasya mukham yakaranam smritam tasmat sangam adhityaiva brahmaloke mahiyate. The very purpose of the Vedangas is said in the last line. That means if one wants to attain moksha, then one should study all these 6 Vedangas. So here in these verses, what happens is the different angas, I mean the limbs of Veda or Shiksha etc. Are attributed to the are compared with the different limbs of Veda Purusha. Let us see how it is. So Chandaha, Chandashastram, if Veda is a Purusha, Purusha means person, then Chandas is the 2 feet of Veda Purusha. Kalpa will be the 2 hands of Veda Purusha and Jyotisham is the 2 eyes of Veda Purusha and then Niruktam is the 2 ears of Veda Purusha and Shiksha is the nose whereas Vyakaranam is the mouth of Veda Purusha. Like that, since all these Vedangas constitute Veda Purusha, the one who studies and understands and is trained in all these 6 Vedangas would certainly be respected in Brahmaloka. That means indirectly saying that he would attain Brahmajnanam or the ultimate Purushartha that is called Moksha. The term Vedanga suggests that just like recitation of Veda, which is ordained as Nityakarma, Svadhyayodhyetavyaha says Veda, every day one should study recite Veda, that is. So along with Veda, all these 6 Vedangas are to be recited every day. So it is a Nitya Karma to recite Vedangas also on a regular basis. Now, let us see as to which Vedanga discusses which part of the knowledge and how is it useful, briefly. So Shiksha, the first one is called Shiksha. In Vedas, we find the word also Shiksha. Since it is Vedic literature, a dirgha, that is Shiksha, is allowed. But in Loka, in classical literature, Sanskrit literature, we call it Shiksha. This is the basic Vedanga that explains as to how letters are born and how to pronounce the letters, the time for pronouncing short, long, etc. letters, and how to read or speak, and different accents that are useful in Vedic recitation, and qualities of good and bad reader, and the general mistakes committed by the speakers, etc. etc. Panini in his Shiksha shows the perfect way of pronouncing pronunciation, offering a simile. Vyaghri yatha haret putran दंष्ट्राभ्यां न तु पीड़येत भीता पतन भेदाभ्यां तद्वद्वर्णान प्रयोजयेत. He is giving a very beautiful natural simile. You just watch a tigress. How a tigress carries its cubs with both of its sharp jaws, but without causing any injury, without hurting the cubs. Whereas and also while carrying, it is afraid of the if it clutches tightly, then it is going to cause a cut on the cub. If it is holds loosely, then it will cause a falling of the cub. Therefore, neither too tightly nor too loosely, the tigress holds its cubs while carrying. Similarly, we have to pronounce the letters without being very neither tightly nor loosely. That is what is explained here. It is how the now for pronunciation of letters, there are 8 places that are in the mouth. So they are enumerated by Panini. How ashtau sthanani varnanam उरह कंठस्यरस्तथा जिह्वामूरन्तु दन्ताश्च नासिकौष्ठौ च धातालु च. सो टु प्रोनौंस दि लेटर्स देर आर 8 प्लेसेस द लाइक चेस्ट एंड देन थ्रोट देन हेड देन दि जिह्वामूला आर दि रूट ऑफ दि टंग देन दि टीथ एंड दि नोस एंड आल्सो बोथ द लिप्स लाइक दैट also the palate. These are the 8 places where the letters are born. So there are pratishakshas for each veda, and they are akin to shiksha. Pratishaksha is for pratishakham, prati shakham, for each shakha there will be one that means yajurveda, samaveda, like that different vedas there will be different pratishakshas. They also discuss these issues, pronunciation, etc. Then the second Vedanga is called Vyakaranam. Vyakaranam is considered to be the most important among the Vedangas. Without Vyakaranam, nothing moves, because even in for study of other shastras or any kind of literature, Vyakaranam, roughly it is called grammar, is essential. So literally, what is Vyakaranam? Literally, it means separating perfect shabdas from the imperfect shabdas. The bottom line is that the sages of Indian origin wished to achieve dharma even through the use of shabdas. If you pronounce the shabdas that are acceptable to Vyakarana, then you will get punyam or dharma. And if you mispronounce or employ words that are not acceptable to Vyakaranam, then you will get papam or sin. The term shabda is untranslatable, as it denotes many things. Shabda means varnaha, that is phoneme, prakriti, pratyaya, pada, vakya, mahavakya, and then avantara vakya, mahavakya, para, pashyanti, madhyama, vaikari, the ordinary sound, that is dhvani, and etc. etc. So shabdanushasanam is a synonym of Vyakaranam, and the system deals with the form of shabda and not artha. Niruktam deals with artha. So Vyakaranam deals with shabda, while Niruktam deals with artha. And there have been 9 Vyakaranas, and the one authored by Panini, who is considered to be the most genius person on earth, is the best of them. Because Vyakaranam, Panini's Vyakaranam, the book is called Ashtadhyayi, having 4000 sutras, deals with both Vaidika Shabdas and Laukika Shabdas. Earlier, there used to be, people use it to study pratishakshas for Vedic literature, whereas for aindram, chandram, etc. vyakaranas for classical literature or laukika shabdas. Shabdas can be put under two headings, vaidika and laukika. So far as the meaning is concerned, there is no difference between vaidika shabdas and laukika shabdas. Swara is important in Vedic literature, and there can be slight difference in the form of certain vaidika shabdas when compared with their secular counterparts slightly. Bhadrangarne Vishrunuyama Devah. Here Kannaihi, if it is a Laukika Shabda, but it is Kannebhihi, because in Veda there may be slight difference in the form of a Shabda but not in the meaning or Artha. So here what happens, Swara is earlier to Panini there were Pratishakshas for Vaidika Shabdas and Vyakaranams for Laukika Shabdas. As far as the Swara is concerned, Panini did not make any Adhikara Sutra like Chandasi, which denotes that Swara or accent like Udata, Anudata, Swarita, etc. is acceptable only in Vedas and or Vedic literature but not in Laukika literature. Therefore, since Panini did not make any such Sutra, this Swara is applicable to both Vaidika Shabdas as well as Laukika Shabdas. But the fact is that in Laukika Shabdas, people while speaking Sanskritam do not give importance to Swara, whereas in Vedic literature, Swara is very important then. So, it was Panini who authored the unparalleled work called Ashtadhyayi. Ashtadhyayi means having 8 chapters. That is a nutshell for the analysis of both Vaidika Shabdas and Laukika Shabdas. Ashtadhyayi consists of roughly 4000 sutras. A sutra means an elliptical sentence, and therefore there the vartikas are amendments in the form of sentences authored by Katyayana and others. And Patanjali authored a great and profound treatise called Mahabhashyam. A special type of commentary on Panini's Ashtadhyayi and the Vartikas of Katyayana at all. As a result, it is called Trimuni Vyakaranam. Since three sages had, built up this system, it is called Trimuni Vyakaranam. The Vyakaranam authored by three munis or sages called Panini, Katyayana and Patanjali. Grammar is a rough translation of Vyakaranam. Vyakaranam is actually not grammar. Vyakaranam includes grammar. Grammar means parts of speech, figures of speech, etc., etc. Vyakaranam includes those things which are discussed under the heading grammar, but not vice versa. So, Vyakaranam cannot be translated as grammar, but grammar is a rough translation, because in other cultures, since Vyakaranam is not there, and since there is grammar and there is some semblance, similarity between this Vyakaranam and grammar, we simply say Vyakaranam means grammar. Rough translation it is, without claim to accuracy. The fact is that the Shabdas fetch dharma, whereas apashabdas acquire adharma, that causes sin. So suppose take a shabda like bhedaha. Bheda is the sadhu shabda or shabda that is a perfect one, acceptable to Vyakaranam, and one can use it in the sense of difference, etc. But some people use bhedha, others say bhedha, some other people say bhedha, etc. All these are called apashabdas. Apashabdas means which are not acceptable to Vyakaranam. So if one employs the shabda bhedha, he will get punyam. And if anybody says bhedha, 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 etc., etc., they all will get sin. That is what is actually, meant here by the term Vyakaranam. Siddhe Shabdartha Sambandhe Lokataha, Lokataha Artha Prayukte Shastrena Dharmaniyamah Kriyate is a first Vartikam of Katyayana, who says by simply learning language, one will be in a position to transform the meaning or knowledge from one person to other person. But here what happens, Shastra says, if you employ the words that are acceptable to Vyakaranam, then you will get not only transformation of meaning, but also dharma, which finally would lead to moksha. Then here, so Panini with his acumen achieved Vyakaranam a place among darshanas such as Vedanta, Yoga, etc. Darshana means one which exhibits the noumen or tattvam which is called Brahman for achieving, which is useful in attaining moksha. So Vedangas, only Panini Vyakaranam only is fit to be called Vedanga because it only discusses the Vedic Shabdas also. Other Vyakaranas like Aindram, Chandram, Kashakratsram, etc., etc., they won't discuss Vedic Shabdas, but they are exclusively useful for Laukik Shabdas. Vyakaranam is described as the mouth of Vedapurusha, thereby suggesting that it is most important among Vedangas. All the Vidyas are based on Vyakaranam. Prayoga Sharanam Vyakaranam, that means Vyakaranam is built depending on the usage. So this is the norm in Vyakaranam. Vyakaranam has got Prayoga as the base. In other words, the Shabdas that are already used in Veda and Loka are being analyzed and registered. Next, the third Vedanga is called Chandas. Chandas means prosody. The term Chandas is used to mean Veda and the discipline related to prosody. In both the senses, the term is used. Here, it is the latter, that is prosody. So, the Vedanga Chandas is described as the feet of Vedapurusha. And Pingalacharya, the author of Chandas Shastram, is considered as a popular authority on Chandas. There are seven chief meters called Brahachandamsi available in Veda. Gayatri, Ushnik, Anushtup, Brahati, Pantihi, Trishtup and Jagati are the seven Chandas, meters that are called seven Chandas, Sapta Chandamsi. That is what is referred to by this word. The Chandas Shastra also discusses Laukika meters along with Vaidika meters. Pingala picks up the origin of Chandas from Veda. Trishtubha yajati, Brahatya gayati, Gayatriya stauti, etc. There are eight ganas called Yamatara Jabhanasa. These are called ganas, and with the help of these ganas, the meters are built. Now, the fourth Vedanga is called Niruktam. This is Arthaha, the Artha is being Nisheshena Uchyate Arthaha Anena Iti Niruktam. So, the meaning part of any literature, any Shabda is being discussed by this. As has already been explained earlier, Vyakarana deals with Shabda while Niruktam deals with Artha. Niruktam is described as the ears of Vedapurusha. Yaska, the author of Niruktam, available today, declares that Niruktam is a supplementary to Vyakarana. He says it is just like a tail of Vyakaranam. The origin of this thesaurus or dictionary is found in Niruktam by the name Nighantu. Nighantu is nothing but thesaurus or dictionary. Yaska puts the gamut of Shabdas under four headings. In Nirukta, the analysis of language also takes place, not only meaning. Before that, so he puts under four headings: Nama, Akhyata, Upasarga, Nipataha. So these are nouns, verbs, prefixes, and some words that are pronounced by Panini, etc., that are used in a specific sense. So according to Niruktam, the verb in a sentence is important rather than the noun. Sattva pradhanani namani kriya pradhanam akhyatam. So the most important aspect discussed in Niruktam is constant change of everything. So when you take anything, thing underlined, anything on earth, it undergoes change by every moment. Yaska asserts that there are six stages for a thing. So a thing, suppose you say one thing does exist, it doesn't exist in the same form, forever. No, it undergoes change at every moment. How? There are six kinds of stages which are called Shadbhava Vikaraha. What are they? Namely, Jayate, thing is born first, then asti, then exists, then viparinamate, it undergoes some change, and then vardhate, it increases, and apakshiyate, then it will start decaying, that means decay will start, and vinashyati, it will perish. So everything on earth has to undergo all these six kinds of changes called bhava vikaraha. The above are called shadbhava vikaraha. Now the fifth vedanga, that is jyotisham, we are going to discuss. So it is also called jyotisham and jyotish shastram. So it is described as the eyes of Veda Purusha. Eyes are so important for a person. Similarly, Jyotisham is so important to understand Veda Purusha. That means to perform yagas, yajnas and other karmas, that are rites that are ordained by Veda. The term Jyotihi means a star or a planet, or any kind of light also sometimes called Jyotihi. So the description which deals with the movement of stars, nakshatras and planets, grahas, and related matters are is called jyotisham. That means jyotisham discusses the movement of stars, planets, etc., and also the results of the very movement in a person's life, etc., is also discussed in jyotisham. So the auspicious or suitable time for the performance of Vedic rites is prescribed by jyotisham. So the muhurta we call sumuhurta, that is good or auspicious time for performing a marriage or any other rite. The shastram is divided into three skandhas. Skandha means part. First one is muhurta skandha, that deals with fixing the auspicious time. The second one is called jataka skandha or hora skandha, dealing with the predictions depending on the horoscope. And the final one is called Siddhanta Skandha, that deals with the preparation of a Panchangam or Almanac. And in India, Panchangams are authored by different Siddhantis. A Siddhanti is one who is a master of Siddhanta Skandha and prepares Panchanga. That they deal with Muhurtas, and Jataka are available every year. And the rituals are held as per the time prescribed therein on a day-to-day basis in the Panchangam. Now, the Lagadhacharya, a great astrologer, compiled three works, each called Vedanga Jyotisham, Archya Jyotisham, Yajusha Jyotisham, and the Atharvana Jyotisham. So it may be noted that Rigveda, which recited with Ganam or music, is called Samaveda. Samaveda is not different from Rigveda, in fact, but except 75 riks are added to what is borrowed from Rigveda. So whatever riks or hymns are there in Rigveda are recited with music or Ganam, therefore, and the same is called Samaveda. The Bhachakram or Zodiac, which is of 360 degrees, it is divided into 12 equal parts called Rashis. Rashi means sign, namely Mesha, Vrishabha, Mithuna, Karkataka, Simha, Kanya, Tola, Vrishchika, Dhanus, Makaraha, Kumbha, Menaha, like that. There are 9 planets useful for this system, namely Ravi, Chandra, Kuja, Rahu, Brihaspati, Budha, Ketu, Shukra. 27 nakshatras are there in the system, like Ashwini, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, Mrugashirsha, Ardra, Punarvasu, etc. A year consists of 12 months, such as Chaitra, Vaishakha, etc. And each month is named after a star with which the moon is associated on the full moon day or Purnima. Nakshatrena Yukta Kalaha is a Pani Sotram which says on the full moon day, the moon stays with one particular nakshatra like Chitra, Vishakha, Ashwini, etc., etc. And following that nakshatra, the month is named after that. Like moon is staying with Chitra Nakshatra on the full moon day, then that particular month is called Chaitra, and so on and so forth. So the horoscope is nothing but a chart that gives an idea of both the good and bad karmas one has to face during the present lifetime. Mathematics or Ganita Shastram is considered as an integral part of Jyotisham. The horoscope people go on for predictions to the astrologers, and what actually it consists of, what does it reflect? The horoscope or the planetary lineup in the horoscope or different dasha, vishay mahadasha, antardasha, vidasha, sokshma dasha, etc. are there. All these things simply tell as to what this person, the horoscopy, his karma is there. To be faced. That means, depending on the punya karma, he will have comfort or sukham, and depending on the papa karma, he will have dukham, due to such as diseases, accidents, other financial problems, etc., etc. So, whatever karma is there in store, whatever you have karma you have achieved during the earlier incarnations or births, that is being reflected here. Karma can be shubha karma, that there is punyam, that causes comfort, and it can be bad karma, that is papa karma, which causes papam, and one has to face for that. So all the four Vedas have got different kalpa. The sixth Vedanga is called kalpa. Kalpyate samarthyate prayogaha atreti kalpa. In Veda we come across so many mantras, literature. But what happens, where to use this mantra, and what is the procedure to be followed? How to perform a particular rite, perform a yaga, a vivaha, a upanayanam, etc., etc. So many karmas are there. So all these, this procedural aspect is explained by Kalpa Shastram. So samarthyate kalpa prayogaha atra iti kalpaha, that is the very derivative meaning. The very procedure is being discussed or prescribed here, therefore it is called kalpa, that is the derivative meaning. In other words, while the mantras for a rite are provided by Veda, the practical part is explained by kalpa. Kalpa Shastram can be put under two headings, Shravata Sutram and Grihya Sutram. Shravata Sutram deals with yagas, etc., whereas Grihya Sutram deals with samskaras such as vivaha, upanayana, namakaranam, etc., etc. Shulbha Sutram is also there. Shulbha means a rope. The Shulbha Sutram is a part of Shravata Sutram. Shulbha Sutram is nothing but geometry, and it is a part of Shravata Sutram, and the same is useful for measuring yajnashalas, the cottages where sacrifices are to be performed, etc. So that is Shulbha Sutram. Shulbha means rope. There is another branch called Dharma Sutram or Dharma Shastram, also called Smriti. Earlier we discussed this, as it is popularly called, is a part and parcel of Grihya Sutram and prescribes dharma in line with Veda. So whatever is said in Veda, it is difficult to understand for all the people. Therefore, the things are simplified and clearly given in classical Sanskrit literature. Therefore, Shrutirivartham Smritiranvagachyat. Smriti, the Dharma Shastram or code of conduct, generally it is referred to, follows the line of Veda as far as Dharma is considered. So whatever is said in Shruti and Smriti, that is Veda and Dharma Shastram, people have to follow that. So all the four Vedas have got different kalpas. The final result of all the karmas is attaining moksha through Chitta Shuddhi, cleansing the mind. We are going to have, we will have karmas. So any karma you perform, the end result will be Chitta Shuddhi or cleansing the mind. So by all this, what we have understood is the Veda is just like a mass of knowledge, and the literature sometimes is difficult to understand, even for scholars. Therefore, to assist the analysis of our clear understanding of Vedic literature, it is there are six Vedangas. Vedangas are nothing but limbs of Veda. If you take Veda as Purusha, these are the limbs of that Purusha or person. So first one, Shiksha deals with pronunciation, Vyakaranam deals with perfection of Shabdas, Chandas deals with prosody, Chandas, Shiksha, Vyakaranam, Chandas, Niruktam deals with the meaning, Jyotisham deals with the auspicious time, etc., etc., and Kalpa deals with the procedural matters, how to perform, when to perform, what is the process. Therefore, Vedangas are very much required to understand the Vedic literature. Therefore, for more details, please visit EPG Pathashala in Flipnet dot ac dot in. Thank you very much.